Hi, Aileen again. I'm standing here with Todd Strickland from Historical Concepts. Todd, tell us about Historical Concepts.
Well, Historical Concepts is an architecture and planning firm. We're out of Atlanta. We were founded in 1982, and we work with developers, we work with cities, we work with homeowners, and we specialize in traditional design. Whether it's new buildings meant to look and feel as if they've been a part of a historic area, or adaptive reuse or renovations, everything we do has a historic style incorporated into it.
So tell me about the value of incorporating a historical design in your new construction for a city.
Well, really, you're starting to see that there's a rebirth in maximizing historic areas as far as tourism goes. If you can have a town that has a unique historic identity, there's a lot of people that want to come and see that. I mean, Savannah's a great example, but there's other towns like Madison that are also well known for that. But you're seeing more and more towns around the state realize that if they have a historic Main Street, that's something that's unique, and you want to take care of that, and you want to protect it, and then you also want to create a vision of what can be to accommodate new growth and revitalization, and that's where we come in.
So give us some examples of some of the cities you've already worked with.
Well, a great city that we worked with just recently is Sonoy. It won the Renaissance Award last year. It's got a Southern Living Idea House that's going on there this year, which is actually the second Southern Living Idea House. They had one there that was there a couple years ago that was the most visited Southern Living Idea House in history. It had 30,000 people come through, and it really was an interesting experience for everybody in the town, because you had all these people come in and see the Idea House, and they discovered Sonoy too. And there's been a real rebirth, revitalization, despite the down economy, that they have all sorts of new investment coming into the town. And it all started with the Downtown Development Authority, where they said, let's create a vision of what could be on our Main Street, again, to protect what they already had, but also allow for new growth that would have a similar feel, design-wise, to what was there already. And that's what we did with them.
Yeah, that's exciting. So, if you're not here, tell us how someone can get in touch with you.
I can go online to see www.historicalconcepts.com, and it has our project information and contact information, and give us a call from right there. 770-487-8041 is our phone number. We'd be glad to work with any historic towns.
Okay, great. And if you are here, be sure to come see Todd Strickland and the gang from Historical Concepts. So we're going to scoot on over here. This is a really interesting diesel engine, and so we're going to find all about this.
You want to interview me now?
Yeah, I do. Sorry, we're live. So tell us your name and your company.
My name is Bill Hewitt, PowerStrokeHelp.com, and we're here at the Georgia Municipal Show displaying, it's called Cyclops is our name for it. It's a training vehicle that's designed to show how to take care and rebuild correctly the Ford PowerStroke diesel engine. I've actually engineered a system of bulletproofing this engine that involves modifications to the engine to make it dependable, run cooler, and get better fuel economy.
So what kind of vehicles have diesel engines, these types of engines?
Well, in the municipal world, ambulances is my background. So ambulances are the number one use in a municipal fleet. There's also work vehicles and whatnot, flatbed trucks, trucks to tow equipment and whatnot, company in municipal fleet might have these type trucks.
So what are some of the biggest concerns with these types of engines?
Well, the biggest concern is finding people to work on them correctly. Even at the dealership level, it's difficult to find somebody who really understands these vehicles. So, and they overheat, and then people run them hard, and then they break, and it costs a lot of money. So I've built a whole business in Buford, Georgia, specifically to deal with this type of vehicle.
And I hear this is your first time at the GMA convention.
Yes, this is my first time to GMA. It's been an outstanding show. Lots of really nice, wonderful people here.
Okay, well, be sure to come see Bill Hewitt. And if you're not here and watching from home, how can someone get in touch with you?
PowerStrokeHelp.com is my website. I have videos there. Or you can reach me at my office in Buford, Georgia at 770-931-4070.
Thanks a lot. Back to you.
Thank you.